So today class cyclotron. Cyclotron is a machine which is used to activate positively charged particles to energy. Who observed cyclotron? Lorentz and Levington first observed cyclotron in the year 1934. Cyclotron is used to the combination of both electric and magnetic field. This combination of electric and magnetic field produce high energy charged particles. What is the principle of cyclotron? When electric and magnetic field mutually perpendicular to each other, electric field makes the charged particles and get activated moving around the space time. So now we release electrical field. The electric field affects the charged particles, positively charged particles, alpha particle, proton, and neutron. The charged particles are get activated moving along straight line. When magnetic field is applied, the charged particles moving in a circular path. What are the position of electric and magnetic fields in a cyclotron? This is the 2-mark question. Electric field makes the charged particles get activated. Magnetic field makes the charged particles moving along the circular path. So what is the principle of cyclotron? Electric and magnetic field are mutually perpendicular. The point is called a cross field. Electric field makes the charged particles get activated to high energy. The magnetic field makes the charged particles moving in a circular path. Cyclotron. Now cyclotron consists of two semicircular hollow disks. This is one semicircular hollow disk. So two semicircular hollow disks. D1 and D2 are two metal containers. The two metal containers called Ds. The two semicircular hollow disks, the metal container is called Ds. The two Ds are connected. D1 and D2 are connected. High frequency AC oscillator. So these cross symbol which represents magnetic field, uniform magnetic field. P is a source, the releasing for positively charged particles. So P is a source, the releasing for positively charged particles. The source located at midpoint, the gap between two metal containers. This is one metal container, this is another metal container. The source is kept the gap between two metal containers. So these two Ds are connected, high frequency AC oscillator. Now here the source releasing power, the source which is releasing power positively charged particles like alpha, proton and neutron. The source which is released, the source P releasing power positively charged particles like alpha, proton and neutron. So now the metal container D, D2 is made negative potential, D1 is made positive potential. The source releasing for positive charged particles, the positively charged particles get accelerated from the electric field. And magnetic field makes the charged particles moving in a circular path. After charged particles arrive at the center of the gap between the metal container, then D1 is made positive potential, negative potential, D2 is made positive potential. Once again, the charged particles are get activated from the electric field, but magnetic field makes the charged particles moving in a circular path. This process may be repeated several times. Then what happens? The velocity of the charged particles increase with increase in the radius of the semicircular orbit. Velocity of the charged particles increase, the radius of the semicircular orbit is also increased. Then the charged particles are get deflected by deflection plate. So the deflection plate collected a large number of charged particles. The number of collection of charged particles is called a beam of charged particles. The beam of charged particles have high energy. The charged particles comes to here. So the beam of charged particles which produce a high energy. So it is the working of cyclotron. So cyclotron used to activate the positively charged particles to high energy. The force experienced with charged particles moving perpendicular direction of the magnetic field is given by F equal to 2Eb sin 90 degree. F is the force, 2 is the charge, V is the velocity, B is the magnetic field. The force experienced with charged particles moving in perpendicular direction of the magnetic field, F equal to 2Eb sin 90 degree. So the sin 90 degree equal to 1, F equal to 2Eb, equation number 1. If a charged particle is moving along a circular path, the force must be directed towards at the center of the circular path, that is centripetal force. The centripetal force F equal to mv square by r, equation number 2. Now comparing from equations 1 and 2 we get, comparing from equation 1 and 2, F equal to 2vv, F equal to mv square by r. Now 2vv equal to mv square by r, qv here v square cancel. So qv equal to mv by r. Then radius of the circular path, r equal to mv by 2v. Now the velocity of the charged particles, the v is a velocity. The velocity of the charged particles in form of v equal to qvr. So qvr you write here. And denominator m. So v is the velocity of the charged particles, v equal to qvr by m. The time taken by the charged particles to go once round the circular path is called period of revolution of the charged particles. Period of revolution symbol capital T. Capital T equal to circumference of the circular orbit 2 pi r by velocity. So period of revolution of the charged particle T equal to 2 pi r by T. Now substituting for r value, r equal to mv by qv. So here mv by qv, v cancel. So then period of revolution capital T equal to 2 pi m by qv. A number of revolutions per second, the charged particles, number of revolutions per second is called frequency. The frequency of charged particles, nu equals 1 by d. So 1 by d, qv by 2 pi m. Nu is the frequency of revolution of the charged particles. The frequency is independent of velocity of the charged particles and radius of the circular path. The frequency is called cyclotron frequency. So now your two fields are combined, electric field and magnetic field are combined. Then high energy of charged particles, high energy means the kinetic energy of charged particles. The kinetic energy formula K equal to half mv square. Now substituting for V value, now V equal to qvr by m. So now kinetic energy K equal to 1 by 2 m into V square. Now V equal to qvr by m whole square. So then kinetic energy KE equals 1 by 2 m into here q square V square. Now r square divided by m square. Now square and m cancel. So kinetic energy KE equals q square V square by r square by 2m. The kinetic energy of the charged particles in a cyclotron, kinetic energy KE equal to q square V square r square by 2m. So now applications of cyclotron. So in examination point 2 mark question, mention any two applications or any two uses of cyclotron. Cyclotron used to accelerate positively charged particles to high energy. Positively charged particles may be alpha particles, proton, deuteron. So when electric field applied, the charged particles are getting activated. So the first uses cyclotron used to activate positively charged particles to high energy. This is a very important point. The first point, cyclotron used to activate positively charged particles to high energy. And cyclotron is also used to synthesis new materials. And point 3, cyclotron, it is used to atomic nuclei with high energy particles to study the nuclear reactions. And fourth one, it is used to produce a radioactive material for medical diagnosis and treatment. So these are four important applications for cyclotron. So finally, limitations of cyclotron. Neutron, being electrically neutral, cannot be activated. Another point, electron is a negatively charged particles, the mass is very small. With increasing small energy to produce high speed of charged particle, electron, high speed for electron. These are two important limitations of cyclotron.